up on you.
That's the new single?
It is indeed the new single.
Come next Monday?
Come next Monday. She's going to become perfect.
Is this
Everything's going to work just great.
Is this your third album?
This is my third album. It's about to come out next week or something.
First two albums went platinum.
Yep.
You're on a roll.
Well, let's hope so.
Well, are all the tunes you're singing tonight from the new album?
Yes, they are. Yes.
You're going to close with You Call Everybody Darling?
Yeah, that's an old song. It's one of two songs on the album that I didn't write. I had an encounter in New York with a cab driver that caused that song to come about. Wouldn't you love to hear it?
Yes, I would.
I was in New York to close out my apartment that I used to have there. They took it away from me this spring. So I did a lot of last time New York kind of things, and on the way out to the airport, I had a lot of time to kill. So my friend and I, we got in just a regular cab and took a regular cab to the airport like the old days. And we both had, you know, southern accents, and this guy was like a really, he was a, I've had a lot of cab drivers in New York. I lived there for 21 years, and this man was a psycho, and I got him for my last cab driver, which was really appropriate. So we get out there, and he starts pulling all this stuff. And to make a long story short, we had a really, really nasty scene. And at one point in the heat of the moment, I called him darling. And he went nuts. I mean, he went nuclear. And when I got back to Nashville, I stewed about this event for a couple of days because it really was very unpleasant, and I don't like that.
What really upset him?
The word darling, it upset him that I was not from out of town in reality, and I was not going to fall for. He was trying to pull a fast one on me, unfortunately, and I knew about it, and I didn't go for it. It enraged him. He hated women. He hated everybody.
How did you address him when you said, use the word darling?
How did I address him?
What was the phrase that set him off?
Well, darling, you have to do what I've paid you to do.
Did he curse you?
Which is the law. I mean, once they take you in the cab, they can't say, well, I don't want to take you so-and-so. They cannot argue with you. Then the customer is right. And that was the case. And
did he want to dump you?
He wanted to dump me. He wanted us to get out and walk and carry bags. He wanted us to, you know, he was just giving us a whole line of bull. And I didn't fall for it. It got really ugly. At any rate, I got back to Nashville, and I started thumbing through some old sheet music, and I saw that song, You Call Everybody Darling. And I said, this is an omen. I'm going to turn a very nasty affair into a money-making affair. And we like that just fine.
I saw you. I was watching television one night, and I saw you in a dramatic role.
Yes.
You had no makeup on.
I had some dirt on my face and no makeup.
You were out of doors. What was that?
That was paradise.
Right. I thought you did a good job.
Thank you.
What is acting in your future?
Well, it might be. I mean, I don't have any plans. I don't have any concrete things. We might try to do something a little later. Right now, I'm trying to just get this third album off the ground. I'd like to do some a little later, but not right now.
Okay. Did it bother you to go in front of the cameras with no makeup and dirt all over you?
At first it did. I thought, oh my goodness, no one wants to be seen like this. But it really fit the character, and their attention to detail on that show was really authentic. And so people were dirty. I mean, how could you not be dirty jumping around on a buckboard for days, you know, traveling around in the dust? How could you arrive in town with this hairdo and lip gloss going, hi, I'm here to shoot the coward.
Tonight on Nashville Now, we are launching the new K.T. Oslin album called Love in a Small Town, which looks like this. And it's her third album, and if she stays right on course, it'll go platinum, as the first two did. And this is from that album. By the way, this album has that wonderful song about Cornell Crawford. You've heard her sing that song. I love that song. Here is Still on My Mind, and here is K.T. Oslin.
Thank you. you're still on my mind.
Thank you very much. Still on my mind. A question for you from the audience, a couple of them. Why do you wear gloves?
Well, someone gave me a beautiful pair of gloves. They were the prettiest things I'd ever had, and they were sort of dress-up gloves, and they went with this great outfit that I had, and I wore them for the first time on the 30th anniversary of the CMA show. That was the first, like, big thing I did down here, and I just put the gloves on to sort of complete my outfit, and people made such a stir out of it, I just sort of got a kick out of it, and so now I wear them when they work. I mean, I don't run around with gloves on going, hi, I'm KT Oslin, see my gloves. But I'll wear them when they're right, you know. I've got some new ones on tonight. Aren't they pretty?
Do the fans send you gloves?
Yes, they do. They send me really cool gloves.
How many pairs do you have?
I probably have over 100.
Okay. Excuse me. Another question from the audience.
Mm-hmm.
Any truth to the way KT got her start, hiring her own hall and inviting producers?
Yes, essentially that's what I did. I did a showcase down here. I put a band together in Nashville, and I brought them down here. We flew on People's Express for $99, and I borrowed money, and I did a showcase here. I did two shows in one day and got absolutely nowhere. Except for one man, Harold Shedd, heard a song of mine that he liked, and he professed an interest in it. So I went back with the remaining money, and instead of eating, I made a demo tape and sent that to him. And that's what got the ball started.
Now, Harold Shedd, it should be noted, is Alabama's producer.
Well, he produced Alabama, absolutely. He's now head of Polygram Records here
but
in
But at that
Nashville.
Time, he was Alabama's
yes,
producer.
Yes, he was Alabama's producer. Yep.
Were you that strapped for money in those days?
Snow was starting to look like a meal at that point.
Oh, that's funny.
See,
I'm sure it
how many ways can you cook snow? Yeah, I was kind of raunchy for a while. I don't ever want to get there again. Anybody that knows that lives in fear of it, I think.
KT Oslin talked about a mean old New York cab driver, and she called him darling. And that's that led her to record this old song. Here's KT Oslin.
Yeah, y'all remember that old song. You call everybody darling. The guitar player remembers it too. But do you remember the verse, Mr. Guitar Player? Though you're always waxing sentimental, your sweet words are all I ever hear. But you don't. Honey, deep down in your heart, you're not sincere. 'Cause you call everybody darling.
as well as you. Make some room for me. Cause if you call everybody yours, then love won't come in knocking at you. And as the years go by, you'll sit and wonder. Something to him around.
How about it?
There's a good start. Yeah, I'm gonna sing the harmonica part now on this because we were too cheap to hire him. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Oh. I'll tell you, honey, you can run your gloves through my hair anytime. Let's see, tomorrow night, Dobie Gray, Dave and Sugar, Billy and Terry Smith, Cousin Benny Pearl, and via Starcatcher, we'll go back to the Mirage Hotel one more time to wrap up our week out there. Now, let's call the roll. would you please applaud Aaron Tippin over here?
Yeah.
Aaron, good job. How about George Lindsay Jr.? And Mark Gray. And George Lindsay Sr.
Yeah.
And the lady with the nice hands, K.T. Oslin. That's our show. Mr. Whitehurst, let's go home. Good night, everybody.
Else does too. Well, another lady whose talent is timeless is K.T. Oslin. Now get a load of this. K.T. Oslin's first song idea came to her on a trip to the bathroom.
It's true.
I'm not lying.
Let me tell you, it was during a visit to tiny Due West, South Carolina, and she noticed some graffiti on the stall there, and the graffiti you see you probably couldn't write about. But anyway, this particular graffiti said, "I ain't never gonna love nobody but Cornell Crawford."
That's true. Now, KT thought that sounded like a great hook, so she turned it into a song. Now, that was years ago, but KT has included the song in her new album, Love in a Small Town. Renee Goodman asked KT if this record will make her the talk of the town.
I'm overworked and I'm overweight. I can't remember when I last had a date.
K.T. Oslin has made a name for herself with songs that deal with real life. And her third album, Love in a Small Town, has the same themes. But K.T. says it has a little different style.
I think it's a little more upbeat album this time. There's a few more happier songs on there than the other one. It's just whatever came along this time is what I put on there.
Uh-huh. Now, since you wrote most of it, is there a certain message?
There are things about that apply to small towns on the album, and it's also things that can apply to any size town. I read something I thought was fascinating, that the 58% of Americans live in towns under a population of 2,900. And I think 3,000 people, that's almost like going to my college, you know, living in a town with my college. Oh, my Lord. You know, I remember what that was. So there's not that much difference between big towns and little towns.
Were you raised in a small town?
No, I was born in a little, tiny little town in Arkansas, but I was just there for 2 weeks. I lived in Mobile for a while. I lived in Memphis. I lived in Managua, Nicaragua, but I was raised in Houston, which is hardly a little town.
Right.
So, no, I was not raised in little towns, but I understand what it is, you know. And your neighborhood is a little town, you know. It's called Come Next Monday. And I would tell you what we would have done if we'd had the time to do it.
Come Next Monday is the first release from the new album, and the video for the song proves that no risk is too monstrous for KT.
It's a real funny video, and I've got a real high sense of humor. I like it, and I thought it was time that we sort of incorporated that in. All my other videos have been sort of serious, and so we had a little crazy fun.
You always have such a great outlook on life. Is that changing any?
I go up and down like everybody. I have good days, I have bad days. But I enjoy my work very much, and I enjoy most of what goes on. And I'm in the business of being entertaining, so
that
you keep your spirits up.
Interesting video, huh? Well, KT's new album, Love in a Small Town, will be released tomorrow. She wrote or co-wrote seven of the nine cuts on the record, and she played keyboards on it as well.
She is so good.
Yes.
Well, KT is a very talented entertainer, just like our guest today. He is an actor, a singer, a songwriter, and much more. Gary Morris.